Hello, everybody. My name is Buzzer.
And I'm Sparky.
Get ready for fun, because you've just joined
the Bedbug Bible Gang.
We are the bedbugs and we like to fly and float and dance and sing. We thank the Lord for everything. We have six legs and we have wings. We are the bedbugs and we like to zip and zoom and say our prayers. We like to climb a lot of stairs. We have antenna in our hair. We are the bedbugs. And we like to tell you stories from the Bible. We are the bedbugs. And we can't wait to tell you stories from the Bible. One, two, three. We are the bedbugs and we like to pray and praise and eat meringue. And if you like the song we sang, you're in the Bedbug Bible Gang. Gang. Ding, diddle, ding, 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 ding.
Hey, Sparky. Are you ready for today's show?
I sure am, Buzzer. What's it about?
Today, we're going to learn all about the first Passover.
Sounds like fun. Hey, Buzzer.
Yes, Sparky?
What's Passover?
Passover is the night God freed the Israelites from slavery.
Oh, I see, Buzzer.
Let's just watch our first story, Sparky. It's called The Story of the First Passover. In Egypt, many years ago, the 12 tribes waited patiently. The time would come, God told them so, when God would set the people free.
What are we waiting for?
I'm not quite sure yet.
400 years had slipped away since they had come to this foreign spot. They worked as slaves each night and day. The work was hard. The sun was hot.
This place is rotten.
The king of Egypt had a plan to keep the slaves right where they were.
That's the Pharaoh. He sure looks grumpy.
But God had sent a special man to lead the people far from there.
I hope this guy can help.
God's servant, Moses, told them all, "Put on your sandals, pack up tight. Be ready when you hear the call. The time is now. We leave tonight."
Hooray! We're leaving!
That's the plan!
Each person heard what Moses said. Each person helped to get prepared. They shared a meal of lamb and bread. They stayed inside and said their prayers.
This is the escape plan?
This is what God said to do.
That night, an angel flew right down to each Egyptian house and home.
Look, an angel!
Don't worry, God's people are safe.
He came with death to every town, but left the Israelites alone.
It passed right over us.
That's what Passover means.
The king of Egypt gave the word. The slaves were all now free to leave.
Get out of here!
I'm ready to roll!
So Moses said, "Let's thank the Lord. God saves all people who believe."
Thank you, God!
We won't forget it!
And now each year upon that date, the Jewish people joyfully all think back and they celebrate the night that God had set them free.
Happy Passover!
This is my kind of party!
Passover a plate, please!
Did you like the Passover story, Sparky?
I sure did, Buzzer. But there were some scary parts I wish we could have skipped.
You mean Passover, Sparky?
That's exactly the part I mean, Buzzer.
Okay, Sparky. Maybe a song will help you feel better.
Oh, goody! I never pass up a song.
Let's sing a song about Moses and the Pharaoh.
We'll help you learn it.
When Moses was in Egypt land, said Moses to the Pharaoh, "Let God's people go, let God's people go, let God's people go," said Moses to the Pharaoh. But mighty Pharaoh took a stand to Moses, said the Pharaoh, "No, they may not go, no, they may not go, no, they may not go," to Moses, said the Pharaoh. But when an angel passed that way, said Moses to the Pharaoh, "Let God's people go, let God's people go, let God's people go," said Moses to the Pharaoh.
The Pharaoh set them free that day to Moses, said the Pharaoh. All God's people go, all God's people go, all God's people go to Moses, said the Pharaoh.
Everyone sing along.
When Moses was in Egypt land, said Moses to the Pharaoh, let God's people go, let God's people go, let God's people go, said Moses to the Pharaoh. But mighty Pharaoh took a stand to Moses, said the Pharaoh, no, they may not go, no, they may not go, no, they may not go to Moses, said the Pharaoh. But when an angel passed that way, said Moses to the Pharaoh, let God's people go, let God's people go, let God's people go, said Moses to the Pharaoh. The Pharaoh set them free that day to Moses, said the Pharaoh, all God's people go, all God's people go, all God's people go to Moses, said the Pharaoh. Good job!
Feeling better now, Sparky?
Yep, my fear passed right over.
Very good, Sparky. Now you can help us play the first Passover game.
Yippee! Can you help me match up pictures from the first Passover story? We can start with this Egyptian pyramid. Where is its match? You found it! Now we can match for this picture of God's special servant, Moses. That's right. The other picture of Moses is right here. Now, find a match for this shiny sun. Right again. You're doing great. How about this picture of Pharaoh? Can you find a match for him? This one's tricky. Wow, you did it again. Just one left. Where is the match for this happy woman? That's right. She's happy because God just freed her from Pharaoh. You found all the matches. Way to go!
That was super, gang. I couldn't have done it without you. And if you thought learning about the first Passover was fun, then you're gonna love learning how the Jewish people celebrate Passover every year.
I love parties, Buzzer. Will there be food?
You bet, Sparky. And at the Passover party, the food you eat tells a super story.
Oh, Buzzer, food can't talk.
Just pay attention to the Passover meal, Sparky. That supper has something special to say.
The night the Israelites were freed from many years of slavery was quite a special night indeed. To celebrate, here's what they need.
This meal is called the Seder.
It's a Passover party.
The meat they eat is lamb, you know, just like they had so long ago.
Why do we eat lamb?
Keep listening.
The lamb reminds them that God saves. God's people are no longer slaves.
That's easy to remember.
Some bitter herbs will help remind of bitter times they left behind.
Ooh, that's bitter.
You're telling me.
And fresh flat bread should do the trick. It lets them know that they left quick.
Someone smashed the bread.
It's called unleavened.
I see.
The salty water stands for tears they cried through all those sad, sad years.
Needs more salt.
Yuck.
The Israelites felt new and clean. That's what this sprig of parsley means. Dip it in water. 1, 2, 3. Now all the people cross the sea.
Hey, waiter. There's a fly in my soup.
I'm crossing the sea.
Each time they eat this special food, they all know that the Lord is good. Just think of God and celebrate. The story's told right on the plate.
What a great story.
What a great meal.
Hey, my dinner is talking.
You were right, Buzzer. That food does tell a great story.
You said a mouthful, Sparky.
Nope. Mom told me not to talk with my mouth full.
Oh, Sparky. 5 of my bedbug friends are hiding on this Passover table. Can you see where my friends are hidden?
And make it quick. I'm hungry.
There's a bedbug hiding by that plate of lamb. Do you see any others? That's it! You found my friend hiding under that flat piece of bread. Keep looking. Can you see any more? Found another one. That bedbug was hidden in the parsley. Good job! Any others? Right! That bedbug was swimming in the salt water. Can you find my last bedbug friend? There she is, hiding in the napkin. You found them all. Great job! Good job, gang. Now that you've cleaned off the table, we can sit back and relax with the bedbug bandoliers.
And now, I'm proud to present the Bedbug Bandoliers with their latest, greatest hit, the Bedbug Bedtime Blues!
It was late in the evening, the sun was sinking low, and my mama just told me that to bed I had to go. I got the blues. Every time I go to bed, so I picked up my toothbrush and I got my toothpaste. But when I squeezed the tube, it flew all over the place. So I got the blues.
He's got the blues. He's got the blues.
You heard what I said. Time I go to bed. Let me tell you about my teddy bear. Well, my teddy bear left me 'cause he wasn't too clean. I'm alone in my bed and he's in the washing machine. Son, don't be scared of big bad wolves and baby bears. Just close your eyes and say your prayers, and soon the morning will be there. Well, that's okay and that's all right to say when my whole room is bright. But as she leaves and says goodnight, why does she turn off all the lights? I got the blues. Time I go to bed. One more verse. Well, I woke up this morning, the sun was shining bright. I made it through last evening, but what about tonight? I got the blues.
He's got the blues. He's got the blues.
You heard what I said.
Thank you, Bedbug Bandoliers, for that brief yet beautiful ballad.
Buzzer, look out! Look out! Look out!
Look out where, Sparky?
Look out there, Buzzer. All those people are waiting for the name of the last story.
Oh, I guess you're right, Sparky.
Yep.
So without further ado, the Bedbug Bible Gang is happy to bring you Splitting the Sea.
Pharaoh set the people free. Moses led them to the sea.
It's great to be free.
It's great to be at the beach.
Pharaoh told his army men, bring those people back again.
The Pharaoh changed his mind.
Look out, Moses.
Moses saw the army come. Moses said, it's time to run.
Let's get moving.
I'm way ahead of you.
But the people said, oh no, there is nowhere else to go.
Oh no, we're trapped by the sea.
Yikes!
Moses said, just follow me. God will lead us across the sea.
But I can't swim.
Moses bowed his head to pray. He knew God would show the way.
What will God do?
What will Moses do?
What will we do?
God told Moses what to do. Moses split the sea in two.
Wow, look at that.
Where? I can't see.
The sea, the sea.
Moses and the mighty crowd crossed the sea on solid ground.
Look at me, I'm crossing the sea.
Pharaoh chased with all his might. Water washed him out of sight.
Wave goodbye to Pharaoh.
You can say that again.
All the people got away. They gave thanks to God that day.
That was amazing.
That was a miracle.
Thank you, God.
I hope you liked our story. The bedbugs love to share the story of how God protected the Israelites when they crossed the sea. It reminds us that God protects each of us every day.
Do you mean that God is always with us, Buzzer?
That's right, Sparky.
That's great news, Buzzer. We should tell everyone.
We just did, Sparky.
Oh, hi, everybody.
Let's all sing a song about the splitting the sea story.
It'll be fun!
And you won't even get your feet wet.
Moses led the people down to the sea. Out marched the crowd, so happy to be free. No, said the Pharaoh to his army men, bring Moses and the people back to me again. Moses and the people saw the Pharaoh come, trapped by the sea with nowhere left to run. Moses trusted God and knew just what to do, so Moses raised his arms and split the sea in two. Moses and the people marching hand in hand, passed through the sea while walking on dry land. Up stayed the water, high above the tide, as Moses and the people go to the other side. Pharaoh and his army following that day, down came the waves and washed them all away. Now Pharaoh could not catch them anymore, so Moses and the people are dancing on the shore.
Everyone sing along!
Moses led the people down to the sea. Out marched the crowd, so happy to be free. No, said the Pharaoh to his army men, bring Moses and the people back to me again. Moses and the people saw the Pharaoh come, trapped by the sea and nowhere left to run. Moses trusted God and knew just what to do, so Moses raised his arms and split the sea in two. Moses and the people marching hand in hand, rode past through the sea while walking on dry land. Up stayed the water high above the tide, as Moses and the people go to the other side. Pharaoh and his army following that day, down came the waves and washed them all away. Now Pharaoh could not catch them anymore, so Moses and the people are dancing on the shore.
Good job!
That song sounded swell.
Sea songs always sound swell.
Say that five times fast. Can you tell which picture from the Splitting the Sea story is different from all the others? We can start with this Moses. Which one is different from all the others?
Good job! This Moses is wearing a purple shirt. How about this picture of Pharaoh? Which one is different?
That's right. Pharaoh is wearing tennis shoes. Now look at this floppy fish. Which one is different from all the rest?
Right again! This fish is flipped all around. Try to find the picture of a horse that is different from all the others.
You got it. That horse is smiling a silly smile. Just one left. Which group of dancing people is different from the others? Look carefully.
Great job! This group is definitely doing its own thing.
You found them all. Way to go! That's all the time you tell have for today, gang. We hope you had fun, and we hope to see you again real soon. And always remember that
Jesus
loves you very much. Bye-bye!
We are the bedbugs, and we like to fly and float and dance and sing. We thank the Lord for every day. Six legs, and we have wings. We are the bedbugs, and we like to zip and zoom and say our prayers. We like to climb a lot of stairs. We have antenna in our hair. We are the bedbugs, and we like to tell you stories from the Bible. We are the bedbugs, and we can't wait to tell you stories from the Bible. One, two. Bedbugs, and we like to pray and praise and eat meringue. And if you like the song we sang, you're in the Bedbug Bible Gang. Gang, ding, diddle, ding, 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 ding.